This has been Principles of Real Estate Practice in Alabama, written by Stephen Mettling, David Cusick, and Jane Somers. Narrated by Julian Kasow. Copyright 2019 by Performance Programs Company. Production copyright by Performance Programs Company. Preface. About the text. Principles of Real Estate Practice in Alabama contains the essentials of the national and Alabama real estate law, principles, and practices necessary for basic competence as a real estate professional, and as mandated by Alabama license law. It is based on our highly successful and popular national publication, Principles of Real Estate Practice, which is in use in real estate schools nationwide. The text is tailored to the needs of the pre-licensed student. It is designed to make it easy for students to learn the material, prepare students for numerous career applications, stress practical as well as theoretical skills and knowledge. It is streamlined, direct, and to the point. It includes multiple learning reinforcements. It has a student-oriented organization, both within each chapter and from chapter to chapter. Its examples and exercises are grounded in the author's many years in real estate education. About the authors. For over 40 years, Stephen Mettling and David Cusick have operated one of the nation's most successful custom training organizations, specializing in real estate program development. Mr. Mettling has also served as vice president and author for a major real estate training and publishing organization. Under various capacities, he has managed the acquisition, development, and sale of national real estate textbooks and publications, as well as directed the country's largest affiliated group of real estate schools. Mr. Cusick, an author and educator with international real estate training experience, has been engaged in vocation-oriented education since 1966. Specializing in real estate training since 1983, he has developed numerous real estate training programs for corporate and institutional clients around the country. Jane Somers has been a writer and educator for over 30 years. She has directed the academic programs for a multi-campus college and has in recent years become an accomplished developer of online and classroom real estate curricula for a national real estate licensing organization, specializing in state licensing laws. Ms. Somers is also active in condominium association management and has served as president of a condominium owners association for 10 years. Chapter 1. The Real Estate Business. In its broadest sense, the real estate industry is the largest single industry in the American economy. Within it, one might include the construction industry, itself often considered our country's largest business. In addition, the real estate industry may be said to include the creation, management, and demolition of every residence and business facility in the nation: offices, warehouses, factories, stores, and special purpose buildings such as hospitals and government facilities. The real estate business would include as well the managing of all the undeveloped land in the country, national parks, forests, and the vast quantity of unused federal property. Real estate professionals are individuals and business organizations whose sole enterprise is performing a real estate-related service or function. A wide range of professions is available to persons wishing to enter the real estate business. Real estate professionals perform the following property-related functions: creation and improvement, management and maintenance, demolition, investment ownership, regulation, and transfer. Creation and improvement. Creating real properties from raw land involves capital formation, financing, construction contracting, and regulatory approvals. The key parties involved in this aspect of the business are generally the developer, the landowner, and the mortgage lender. Also involved are market analysts, architects, engineers, space planners, interior designers, and construction subcontractors. Experts who manage the legal aspects of the development project include real estate attorneys, title companies, surveyors, property insurance companies, and government regulatory officials. The brokerage community, with the assistance of professional appraisers, usually handles the ownership and leasing transactions that occur over the many phases of development. Management and maintenance. All real estate, whether raw land or improved property, must be managed and maintained. The two principal types of managers are property managers and asset managers. Property managers and their staff oversee specific properties on behalf of the owners, making sure the condition of the property and its financial performance meet specific standards. Asset managers oversee groups of properties or portfolios. Their role is to achieve the investment objectives of the owners as opposed to managing day-to-day operations. Maintenance personnel include engineers, systems technicians, janitorial staff, and other employees needed to maintain the property's condition. Demolition. Demolition experts, in conjunction with excavation and debris removal experts, serve to remove properties that are no longer economically viable from the market. Investment ownership. A specialized niche in the real estate business is the real estate investor who risks capital in order to buy, hold, and sell real properties. In contrast to property owners whose primary interest is in some other business, the real estate investor focuses on identifying and exploiting real estate investment opportunities for profit. The real estate investor provides capital and liquidity to the real estate market. Regulation. All real estate is to some degree regulated by the government. The principal areas of regulation are usage, taxation, and housing administration. Professional regulatory functions include public planners, zoning administrators, building inspectors, assessors, and administrators of specific federal statutes, such as federal fair housing laws. Transfer. Rights and interests in real estate can be bought, sold, assigned, leased, exchanged, inherited, or otherwise transferred from one owner to another. Real estate brokers and the broker salespeople are generally centrally involved in such transfers. Other professional participants are mortgage brokers, mortgage bankers, appraisers, insurers, and title companies. Property type specialization. In addition to specializing by function, many professionals also specialize in the type of property they work with. According to the purpose of ownership, properties are classified as residential, commercial, or investment properties. Residential property refers to property that is owned and used for habitation. Such properties may be further classified in terms of how many families they are designed to house, whether they are attached to other units or detached, and so forth. Commercial property generally refers to retail and office properties, but may also include industrial real estate. The term commercial relates to the fact that the property can potentially generate income from a business's usage. Investment property refers to any property that is held by its owners for investment purposes. All classifications of property may be investment properties. Generally, however, the term does not refer to owner-occupied residences, even though such properties constitute an investment. Apartments, condominiums, cooperatives, and single-family homes may be considered as investment property if non-occupants own the property for investment purposes. These properties are also referred to as residential income properties. According to use, the following classifications of real properties are commonly accepted. These categories are not absolute, since properties often have overlapping uses. A bank, for example, may have retail as well as office operations. An industrial distribution facility may include extensive office space. A retail center may contain offices. Special purpose properties include publicly or privately owned recreational facilities, government buildings, churches and schools, and so on. Real estate brokerage. Most newly licensed practitioners choose to begin their real estate careers in residential brokerage. Primary real estate brokerage activities involve performance of one or more of the following tasks: locating a buyer for a seller, locating a seller for a buyer, locating a tenant for a landlord, or locating a landlord for a tenant. A seller, buyer, landlord, or tenant hires a broker to procure the opposite party to the sale or lease transaction. To help get the job done, the broker hires licensed agents as assistants. The brokerage company, in its simplest form, consists of a broker and the broker's agents, who work together to locate buyers, sellers, tenants.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.